afternoon, everyone. This is Tube 87. And to those of you who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you're having a happy and a blessed Sabbath. Now, I'm going to do a quick video today to get me back in the groove of things. I've been here. I've been doing studies. I just haven't been putting them in video form. I've been writing a lot of them down, though, because I do love studying. But I'm going to do one and put it on video for y'all today. And it's coming from Romans 12, 2. And we're going to be talking a few minutes about conformity to the world and what the Word has to say about conforming to the world. And go with me now to Romans 12, 2. Romans 12, 2, it reads, it says, "And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove that what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God." Now, the Word tells us that we are not to conform to the world. We are to be transformed by the renewing of what? Our mind. So let's look into this a little bit deeper and see what it's telling us a little more. But it should be fairly simple as is. But you know me, I like to break it down to help with that clarity that some of us constantly seek. So go with me to 1 John 1. 1 John 2:15, it reads, it says, "Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him." The Word says, love not the world, nor the things in the world. Money, fame, success, all these things you can get caught up in. If you love the world over the Father, then the love of you, the love of him is not in you. So we have to understand that people think that you can tow both sides of the rope. You can't. You have to be on his side and forsake the rest. Now, we can live in the world and not be of the world at the same time, meaning we live according to what he wants us to do. As we live in the world, we don't let the world conform us or cause us to conform to it. For example, you can't be partying on Friday night and Saturday night up in clubs and all these things, and then Sunday you step up in the church, for those who keep Sunday, since the majority of folks do, you can't step up in church on Sunday and claim to love him. You love the things of the world. If you loved him, if the love of him or for him was in you, you would give that up. The Father has a set of standards and morals that we're supposed to be living by. We can't be doing all these things of the world and then turn around and claim to love him and claim that we're his children, because other people watch us. Just as soon as you step in church, the gossipers are going, "Yeah, so-and-so was in the club last night. Now look at him up in here." And those who don't believe use you as their justification for continuing not to believe. This is part of the reason why the Father says the love of him is not in you. You can't represent him and do as the world. We have to set a standard. You have to be willing to be different, set apart from the world. People already know how to approach you and address you and confront you and all these things when they know that you are not of the world. People sit back and watch and wait to see that you're doing as the rest of the world so they can treat you the same. I don't want people to treat me the same. Treat me as someone different. Treat me as someone odd, because everything different, strange, odd, weird, what have you, that I'm doing is hopefully and prayfully for the Father. I want people to view me as that person. So I take a little pride when people don't approach me as they do everyone else in the world. And I see this even in my own workplace. People approach you differently because they know you're not like everyone else. Now, Matthew 6:24 tells us also that no man can serve two masters. For either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. He cannot serve God and mammon. So you can't serve the world and the Father. You gotta do one or the other. Anyone fronting They're deceiving themselves. You're serving the world. If you think you can go out here and do all this worldly stuff and then serve the Father at the same time, you're deceiving yourself. So you got to make a choice. Do one or the other. The Father is not acceptant of anyone serving the world then claiming Him. So, simply put, we are not to be conformed to the world. Now, I'm going to do a second part to this video talking about the renewing of our mind. What that means, it's simple. It's only a couple minutes to tell us what that means. But I want to get the point across first that we cannot serve two gods, the world and the Heavenly Father. We can't serve them both. We have to serve one or the other. And with that being said, remember, as always, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 2Bay7. I'm out.